Okay, we have studied in the previous to previous lecture about the classification. In that classification, we have done on the location of amino group with respect to COOH group. They are divided into how many types? Basically, three types: alpha amino acid, beta amino acid, and gamma amino acid. Out of which, alpha amino acid are only essential and most found in the nature. Are in the human beings, are living things. Okay, so now let us come back to the next type of classification, that is based on the number of NH3 and COOH groups. Okay, or NH2 also you can say amino. Okay, so amino acids suggest that there should be NH2 and COOH, but there is no restriction about the number of COOH group should be one. There is no restriction about number of NH2 group should be one. Okay, so there can be more than one amino groups, more than one acidic groups. So based upon that, if number of amino groups are exactly equal to number of COOH group, then they come under the neutral amino acid. Okay, when number of amino groups are more than the number of acidic group, then it is called as a basic amino acid. Then when number of acidic groups are more than the amino group, then they are called as acidic amino acid. Neutral amino acid, basic amino acid, and acidic amino acid. Okay, in this one, number of NH2 groups should be equal to number of COOH group. Okay, so for these examples, there is an integer type. If they wanted to give, how many of the following are basic amino acid, how many of the following are neutral amino acid, then like that they may give. If they wanted to make it more complicated and make it for AIIMS or further IIT advanced examination, they may take number of amino acid is equal, number of neutral amino acid is equal to X, then number of acidic amino acids are Y, then X plus Y by Z, like that they may complicate it, but concept will be same. Okay, so the question, how the question will be asked in the examination, that also you should know, so that your preparation must be in that direction. Okay, so here glycine is an example of neutral amino acid. Okay, so like that I will tell you amino acid group. After I give you amino acid, it becomes your responsibility to classify them and leave some space. Okay, after I give you the list of amino acid which are in syllabus, you will segregate into neutral amino acid, basic amino acid, and acidic amino acid. Okay, then it will be easy for you to directly attend the questions in the examination. Okay, so for only one example I am giving it here, like that some more examples will be there. Out of the syllabus amino acid, you will segregate on your own. That will give you a practice. Then basic amino acid. In the basic amino acid, number of NH2 group will be more than the number of COOH group. Okay, for this I am giving one example, lysine. Okay, so once you know the structure of the lysine, you will understand the way of separation. Otherwise I will give one more also, arginine, arginine. These are the two examples. You will understand how to identify the basic amino acid. In this one, number of amino groups are less than the number of carboxylic group. Okay, then here examples are aspartic acid. Okay, and second example is glutamic acid. These are the two examples where number of acidic groups are more than the number of amino groups. Is the classification okay? Classification based upon number of amino and COOH group, they are divided into three types. Based on the position also, they are divided into three types. Okay, major three types, you can keep it at four or five types also, but there is no use. And in that also, you should remember alpha amino acid more basically. Okay, note down this, then we will go further. Okay, some interesting facts like glycine we have discussed, proline we have discussed, some more interesting fact also we are going to discuss. But before, to make it interesting, you should know the basic knowledge. Okay, so interesting fact is about the stereochemistry of alpha amino acid. Okay, alpha amino acids are optically active except one thing. What is that? Glycine. Okay, glycine is the only amino acid which is optically inactive. Rest all will have optically active in the sense they have chiral center. Okay, so in the chiral center there will be a configuration we will use. Okay, lot of confusion about the L, levo and dextro, small d and small l. Okay, capital L and capital D, capital R and capital S. Okay, so these are the configurations. This is experimentally determined. These two are depending on the structural formula given to us. Understood? Capital D and L. Normally we will write it as a DL, driving license. Okay, and RS configuration. So in the that basics you should have. Regarding that only I am going to tell you. See, one intersection of the two line, this intersection represents what? The intersection of two lines in the stereochemistry represents number of intersections of two perpendicular lines equal to, very bad, number of chiral centers. What is that? Number of chiral center. This shows that one chiral center is there. Is that understood? Number of perpendicular intersections will show the number of chiral center. Here one intersection means what is that? It is having one chiral center. Okay, suppose if I write like this, that means two chiral center. This is not written as a perpendicular line intersection because it is not chiral center. Is it understood? So that all we have studied, and we will study, or we will go for the techniques in the forthcoming classes. Okay, so this is the intersection. Understood? And depending on the first chiral carbon atom, most electronegative group represented on the right side or left side, they are denoted as D and L. And according to rules, priority rules, if they are going clockwise or anti-clockwise, then we will assign the configuration as R and S. Okay, the both are different, but there is one similarity, one technique to convert D and L to R and S. Okay, so I am talking about this. This we cannot do anything. This is not in our hand. Practically, we will determine if my optical plane is going like this, and after passing this, it is rotating right side. Okay, this is the optical line. This is electrical wave. Electrical wave is going like this and rotated in the right side direction. That is dextro. It is left side direction, levo. This is practically determined. Okay. So, but way of representation will differ in the D and L and R and S. We can represent in R configuration. We can represent in S configuration. We can represent in D, capital D and capital S. Understood? Now coming to this part, the majority of alpha amino acid in biological world are L series. What series? L series. Okay. So before that, what is that L series? Okay. L series, suppose you are given with, this is the chiral center. You are given with NH3 plus. Okay. Hydrogen, COO minus and CH3. Now I will ask you people, suppose A, B, C and D. Where must be C kept? Sorry, where must be COO minus kept? Where COO minus should be kept? At which position? Option A, option B, option C or option D? Very good. Always you have to keep the most oxidized carbon at the top position, COO minus. Okay. while writing D and L configuration or R and S configuration, these are the basic rule. Most oxidized carbon is this one. It should be kept at the top, and methyl group must be kept at which position? Methyl group must be kept at which position? Which position? A, B, C, D. A already over, B, C, D. Where you will keep the methyl? Where you will keep the methyl? Very good. Least oxidized must be kept at the bottom most position. Okay. So carbon is having hydrogen, so least oxidized. Carbon is having more oxygen, most oxidized. Most oxidized on the top, least oxidized at the bottom. And there is no rule that where should be NH3 kept, where should be H can be kept. Suppose for the time sake, I am writing NH3 positive and hydrogen here. Okay. So these two are must. This we have a choice. Okay. So there will be one more possible structure. NH3 positive, COO minus, hydrogen and CH3. Okay. Now who will tell these two the relation between A and B R? The relation between A and B R. The relation between A and B R. Very good. N and Schumer's. Okay. These two are non-superimposable mirror images. These two are non-superimposable mirror images. Their relation will be N and Schumer's. But non-superimposable non-mirror images, then they are called as non-superimposable, but not mirror images, then they are called as, they are not superimposable. Very good. Diastereomers. Okay. If they are not mirror images, but not superimposable also, then they are called as diastereomers, but they should have at least dash dash. Who will tell? For diastereomer, they should have at least, is it possible to draw the diastereomers in this one? Is it possible to draw the diastereomers of these? No. Very good. At least two chiral center must be there. Here it is having only one chiral center, so we cannot draw the diastereomers. Is it understood? Now, who will tell out of these which is capital D, which is small d, sorry, capital L? Which is capital D and which is capital L? Capital L and D, that is not small and small L and D. Okay, you cannot say. This is dextro D. This is L. Here, with respect to the methyl group, this is on the left hand side, most electronegative, like OH minus and all, NH2 plus, this is L. And with respect to this, this is on the right side. Right side means Greek language dextro. So dextro, NH3 positive is on the right side. So dextro and levo. Is it understood? Note down this. Then we will know the technique. One exception or one interesting fact is there that I am going to cover. Write down. As I told you, there are two types of representation, D and L and R, S. Okay. So if in generally L of this representation is equal to S isomer, what isomer? S isomer. Okay. As per the D and L configuration and comparison, when you do it, normally L isomer of alpha amino acid I'm talking about. Okay. Alpha amino acid I'm talking about, then normally L is generally S isomer out of R and S configuration. L will be generally what? S isomer. This is for what? Alpha amino acid. But there is one amino acid, L cysteine. It is L. It is supposed to be S isomer, but it is R isomer. R configuration. But they will ask reason it is not exception, because it contains the sulfur atom. Sulfur atom gets the priority over the other. So reason, what is the reason? Due to the presence of sulfur atom. Okay. L-cysteine is exceptionally R configuration instead of S configuration due to the presence of sulfur atom changes the priority. Note down this very important question. Okay, next write down based upon next classification. Classification based on source. Okay, source. So they are divided into two types. Essential amino acids, and second one is non-essential amino acids. Okay, essential amino acid and non-essential amino acid. So see, heading is something else and question is something else. What is that? It is asking about the from where it is prepared, but here word is whether they are essential or non-essential. Okay, so essential amino acid means the amino acid which we required in the living things, we required through the diet. Okay, write down essential amino acids which are required to be given through the diet. Okay, through the diet. Understood? So most of the people, they feel that non-essential means just they will make it opposite. The non-essential amino acids are not required in the diet. No. Actually, they are already prepared in the human body itself, synthesized in the biological system. So extra we need not to give through the diet. It is not that they are not essential. What is it written? The essential amino acids are the amino acids which are required to be given through the diet. Okay? In our food, it should be included. That's why they are essential amino acid. It does not mean that non-essentials are not required for our body. They are required for our body, but the source is our body itself. You need not to additionally give through the diet. Okay, so these are naturally produced in the body itself and these are to be externally provided. That's why this is given as a source. Is it understood? Non-essential amino acids. Okay, so the amino acids which need not to be included in the diet but required by the body. Okay, so which need not to be included in the diet but synthesized in body itself. So not essential, externally. Is it understood? Okay, examples of essential amino acid. These are the examples, and as a memory technique, it hall TV. Okay, brought from MP. Understood? It hall TV brought from MP. Is it understood? It means isoleucine, threonine, histidine, arginine, lysine, leucine, tryptophan, valine, methionine, phenylalanine. These are the essential amino acid. With memory technique, note down. Okay, non-essential amino acids are these 10. Glycine, proline, like this. When you revise, like these two are examples of non-essential amino acids. Also examples of what? Glutamic acid and aspartic acid, also examples of. They are examples of non-essential, also examples of. Who will say fast? So same compound can be example of many or exception of many, like glutamic acid, aspartic acid. We have studied in the classification based on number of. there we have studied this is acidic amino acid, this is acidic amino acid. Glycine have you studied or not? Proline we have studied. Like that only you have to revise so many directions. Then only you will be able to answer without confusion. Okay, next classification is classification based upon the nature of side chain. Okay, first is about the with respect to position of amino group. Second is with respect to number of amino and COH group. Third is with respect to what? Third amino acid, whether it is already source. If it is synthesized in the body, then it is called as a non-essential. If it is not synthesized but required for the growth, then they are called as a essential amino acid. Now, fourth type of classification is based upon the side chains. First one is non-polar side chain and polar side chain. Then acidic side chain and basic side chain. Okay, note down this, and out of this, I will write examples of each. Okay, these are the examples of non-polar side chains. These are the examples of non-polar side chains. Alanine, okay. So one example I will take you, alanine. Alanine will be like this. One side it will be hydrogen, another side it will be methyl, okay. So this is the COO minus and this is the NH2, okay. So this side chain is non-polar. What is this? Side chain is what? Non-polar. Like that you should be able to identify. After this, what you will do? Write all amino acid, whether it is essential, non-essential, whether it is non-polar side chain or polar side chain, whether it is acidic side chain or non-acidic side chain, or whether it is acidic alpha amino acid or basic alpha amino acid, whether it is alpha amino acid, beta amino acid, like that for every, like alanine you will take, whether it is alpha, beta or gamma. Okay, after that, whether it is neutral amino acid, acidic amino acid or basic amino acid. After that, whether it is essential or non-essential. After that, whether it is polar, non-polar. After that, whether it is acidic side chain or basic side chain. Like that, every detail about each and every amino acid, you should be able to identify if you are given with the structure. These are all things are given in the NCERT or academy book. The structures are given. I expect all of you should be able to identify from the structure. Will you be able to do this or not? Like alanine, I told you, it is CH3 here, COO minus, and let us take NH3 positive, and here it is hydrogen. Okay. Now tell me whether it is alpha amino acid, beta or gamma. Who can tell from this structure? Whether it is alpha, beta or gamma? Alpha amino acid, very good. It is acidic, neutral or basic amino acid? Acidic, basic, neutral amino acid. Which amino acid? Very bad. See, equal number of one amino group is there, one COO group are there, neutral. Is it understood? So like that, you should be able to classify each and everything, whether it is essential or non-essential, whether it is polar, non-polar. Okay, like that you have to identify. Is it understood? Next, polar side chains. Okay, depending on the examples, depending on the polar or non-polar, examples are these four are example: aspergine, glutamine, serine and threonine. Okay, next one is class acidic side chain example: aspartic acid, glutamic acid, cysteine and thiosine. T-Y-R-O-S-I-N-E. Okay, next and last classification is basic side chain. Examples of basic side chain. Four parts are there, classification based on side chain: acidic, basic, polar, non-polar. Arginine, histidine and lysine. Noted?